Hello, welcome to a new tutorial presented by the SHLZB. In this tutorial, we are going to see conditional statements. Conditional statements are consisting of the if statement, we have the if else statement, we have the if else if statement, and else statement. And lastly, we have the switch statement. And the switch statement is like a loop which consists of multiple if-else-if statements. So we are going to take an example. Let us have two integers. We have an integer a equals to 10. And we also have, we place a semicolon first because we see the error. We also have another integer, integer b, which is equals to 12. We have this. Now, we are going to write some if loops. We say if addition, because we can place here addition, and write add a new integer. Integer, we declare and initialize immediately. So we have in add, you say add is equals to a plus b. This is semicolon. Next, on the next line, we can now do the comparison. We have it in one place. You know that this comparison here is going to produce a Boolean expression, which is going to tell me that either a true or false. If the add is actually true, if I say add is greater than zero and add is actually greater than zero, then it's going to be a true statement and it's going to send up a true value, a Boolean true. And if true is going to enter into the statement. So let's see. We say if add is greater. So we say if add is greater than 12, then it implies that what are you going to do? I come out with my if statement. I count. So this is if add greater than that. Now non do count. I've forgotten that count is in C++. Here is system dot out dot print f or print ln. So I do print So you see, these are all the functions which are stored inside the system out. So these are all the prints which can be found there. So you have print, I wonder you should print. Ellen. Print ln in bracket, then write what I wish it to write. The value is greater than 12. So that's what I want it to write if it is greater than 12. Now you can write else if, that's the next conditional statement, else if we place into it add less than 12, come out, write, we say, you can copy this and you paste here. Now you write here, you say that the value is less than 12. If the value is less than 12. And you write else if in bracket, you write, so you write here else. You place it. Here is not an else if, but an else. You know that if the value is an integer, because you've placed it in an integer, and we said the integer is a plus b. So if the value is an integer, as you've already done, and we know that it's an integer, it must either be greater than 12 or less than 12 or equals to 12. So the last one I'm going to write here is else. I copy here and I paste here. Else I say the value is equals to 0. Come and write the value is equal to 0. Equals to 12 instead. So I compare with 12. The value is equals to 12. And I have all this. So this is my if else statement, else if and else statement. So I'm capable of also doing the switch. But one point to note with the switch is that upon doing the switches, you are involved with case. In each case, you are placing we write switch as such. When you have this switch, you place in the bracket the variable you want to compare it. Now, upon having a variable, you can go to the next line and you write the case. There is the first case where the variable will be equals to 20. Let's see. When the variable is 20, you write the column as such. After writing the column, you go to the next line and you write the statement you want. So each case is the if statement which are involved. And after that if statement, when the particular if statement is being performed, there is a break which come out. So that's why we compare the switch statement as a loop which consists of many or multiple if statements. So the switch statement is compared as a loop which consists of multiple if else statements. So if else statement is true, then it's going to break and come out of the loop, else it's going to remain the loop. That's why if you don't use the word break in switch variables, you're going to realize that the compiler is going to refuse, because you are going to stay in that loop continuously. That's why it's not going to compile and going to give you an error that you're going to place the break there. So this particular program you have, there is no underline, so I think there is no error. You come here, you compile, and you run. So there is an error here, actually. So the error comes because there is an open statement here for the public static void, but there is no close statement. Yeah, the close statement is for the else. So I have to place here for the else, in close bracket. When I click here, I see that it's open here. It's similar to that. When I click here, the same one here. It's opening at this point, closing at this point. So I down do the same thing. I run, then I see the value is greater than 12. So it does a comparison for me. So I do the addition. Addition is 12 and 10. When it does the addition, I see now the value is greater than 12, and that's the answer. So from here, we can see that it will mark the end of conditional statement seen in Java. Thanks for your kind attention.